What's up, everybody? Welcome to a new episode, and I think we're about to do this little love mission right here, whatever you call it. Alright, let's see what happens. Let's see if I can craft anything.
Thank you.
Thank God.
Yeah. People will always complain. We're alive, and that's what counts.
God damn it. I hear Barney got himself into trouble again.
Oh, you're always so negative about things, Naira.
Because you don't understand me. No one understands me. And what I'm doing is the essence of survival.
The essence of survival? What are you talking about?
Want to find out? Just close your eyes. What do you perceive?
Well, I hear noises.
Yeah? What else?
Oh, something stinks.
Exactly. The smell. Impulses going straight from the senses to the limbic system, triggering an emotional response. Memories. The well-being of the mind.
But that smells like shit.
What did you expect? What do you think people use as fertilizers around here?
Too much information.
Sorry.
So, who are you and what are you doing here?
Before the fall, I used to work in a fragrance manufacturing company. I consider myself lucky to have been professionally active within the only century when the world actually smelled nice. Now it's back to normal. So I asked myself, how can I change that? What scent would make people the most happy in this miserable world?
I sure hope you don't mean smelling like shit is the essence of survival.
Of course not. I have this really exciting idea for a new fragrance. People are going to pay a fortune for just a whiff. I called it Turn Me On, and it's almost finished. I just need some scraps for the heart note.
What do you mean, scraps? For a fragrance?
Oh, yes. Metal scraps.
Ah, so Turn Me On will be an aphrodisiac for robots, then.
Good one.
You'll find out when it's time, if you bring me some scrap, along with some lavender. In return, maybe I'll let you in on my secret.
Nara said she needs lavender for her perfume, too. Now that makes more sense. Metal scraps. Nara wants them. Oh, I hope this isn't some wild goose chase. Making perfume out of metal sounds absurd. Here, your, ingredients.
Mmm, good. I wish there was more oil on the metal scraps, but...
Oh, Naira, can't you just be thankful for what you've got for once? She gives me this shit every day, I swear.
Okay. Okay. Voila! It's ready. Here, smell it.
Wow. It smells... It's... Oh, boy, it's like heaven. What is it?
Silly little boy. Too young to know, aren't you? It's new car smell.
A car?
Are you disappointed? The scent of luxury is the base note. The smell of confidence is the heart note. And the fragrance of risk and adventure is the head note. All you dream about is to turn it on and drive away into the distance. Thanks so much for helping me out. Unlike some people. Here, have this. I rubbed it with Turn Me On. This'll remind you to tune into your sense of smell now and then.
All right.
You hear? They say water restrictions are coming. Take a good look at this barn. It's going to be gone soon. How do I do this? From what Harvey told me.
Apparently, there are folks using effective living for medicine. anything about this Night Runner thing? Don't listen to what I say.
We better be careful. All clear. Let's keep going.
Hey, yeah, brother. Table leg.
I'd clear out before he pisses people off.
You some kind of freak? Go. Away.
Hey, then. Fancy a bun?
Out, we're all gonna be fucked. PK and civilian alike. A
true.
Little space, please.
Sorry, brother.
Inhibitor container detected.
You gotta get here. Go fuck.
It is so odd.
Come on, bro.
Barney got himself into trouble again.
Yeah, he did.
inside, man.
I have lost them all.
But who's gone? Do you need help?
Oh, no, my friend. Thank you. But there's nothing to be done here.
But why? Who did you lose?
My fish. My precious fish. Can you imagine what it's like to keep fish when water is so hard to come by? But they were my friends. My teachers.
What the fuck?
Why would you sacrifice water for fish?
But why not?
Because water is expensive. It's a rare commodity.
Oh, I know that. I had to give away almost all I had. My supplies, a flower, and my father's weapons. But they can't survive without the water, of course. And out there, in the world, who knows how many fish are left? Most water has been polluted. Oh, all the dead fish I've seen floating belly up. Such a sad sight.
Why are fish so important to you?
Can I ask you a question in return? Why is this weapon so important to you?
I need it to protect myself, you know, to survive.
Ah, you see, it's all so subjective, isn't it? What's necessary, what's not? For me, fish are fundamental to existence. Fish teach you everything you need to know about life.
So, what did you learn from fish?
Oh, how much time do you have? Because they've been teaching me for years. They taught me how to listen to others. They're great listeners, you see? And they helped me sleep. Have you ever seen a sleeping fish? So still, so peaceful. They don't mind being stared at all the time, and aren't bothered when rude people knock on the walls of their tank. Why is that? Patience. Oxygen is important. Almost as important as water itself. Have you ever seen what happens when water lacks oxygen? Well, I could go on and on. But I guess it's not the same if it's not coming from the fish themselves.
What the fuck is this guy talking about?
And now I'm curious, where are your fish?
Unfortunately, like I said, my fish are not with us anymore. They're gone.
What happened?
Someone ate them.
Wait, someone ate your fish?
Someone broke into my home and ate all of my fish. Then he drank all the water.
The water you sacrificed so much for. Who? Tell me. Want me to go after him?
Nah, forget about it. I think I know who it was. I saw discarded fish bones in front of his place. But let's forget about it.
What? You don't want revenge? He ate your fish.
One of the many things fish teach you, as I mentioned, is patience and accepting what fate brings you. Once you watch them for a while, just swimming in their tank, they don't question where they are. They don't complain that the tank is too small. They just are.
Wait, what? So let me get this straight. You spent everything on the water for your fish, then someone ate your fish and drank that water, and yet you're not angry?
Oh, I was angry. But what does anger do for me?
Nothing.
It causes nothing but negativity and remorse. Maybe one day we'll fish in rivers and oceans again. Fishing. Ah, yes. Fishing can also teach you a lot about life.
You sound like some kind of fish monk.
I'm poor as a monk now. That is for sure. Farewell, my friend. I'm sorry you can't learn anything from my fish.
You know, they used to call this time of day the... Golden hour. Don't see what's
best
golden
quality
about it, but hey.
Sophie has interesting people with her. Like a pilgrim, apparently.
Command wants the citizens to know they have the situation under control. Be extremely cautious. Remember, these are the followers of the infamous Colonel Williams.
Inhibitor container detected.
Once upon a time, people only had bows, arrows, and spears.
Come on, bro.
Man, I'm so thirsty.
Earn one degree, then another. Gave up on a third degree. Managed a PhD.
But... Excuse me.
you
Hey everybody, I guess that's the end of this episode. When we pick back up, we'll be at the Baser. Appreciate everybody.